We're actually on our way back up there again now to do a right front wheel bearing. Went up, checked out a little bit of a crunching and grinding noise in the right front wheel. So we're gonna get right on that one. Get this one done nice and quick. First, we're going to need to get this thing jacked up in the air, get that wheel off.
Heck.
That's all loose. All right, let's get this knuckle detached. Come on. This is how you know a tie rod end is good. You lift it up and it doesn't drop right back down. Sacrificial socket that fits right on the top of that yoke. You can have the 3-pounder. That worked nice. Alright. Ooh, that looks gross. Now we know why this bearing was making a ton and a half of noise. So, it's kind of a lot of a mess right there. Alright, clean all of this up. Get most of that cleaned up in there. Got some scaling right there we gotta chip out. But that'll all make this wheel bearing a lot easier to remove. There's our circlip. Get that circlip out and clean up around that too. A small chisel, small hammer. And we'll grab the snap ring pliers. Yeah, wasn't able to find my snap ring pliers, but I do have my modified needle nose pliers that are modified specifically for this reason. Nice and easy. Now we can turn this over. And let's clean that up a little bit more first. Pretty good. I suspect that their lip, yeah, there's a lip on the edge right here. This bearing has a tiny little lip on the very edge of it that has to be on the outside of this. So now we gotta flip this over, probably just pound that bearing straight out. Looks like it moved a little bit. Alright. Probably should use a company receiver on this. That fits in there, cool. 180, so that's still not wanting to move, hey? Okay, well, let's try this just a little differently then. Right here is facing inward, facing out this that way. Let's get all the inside of this cleaned up. Sure, you got that little lip facing upward. Little lip faces in. Now, small hammer, lightly tap around the edges. Press in the middle of the bearing because that'll damage it. All the way down in, snap ring back down in. Snap rings back in. Bearings all down and in place. Now we gotta get this one off. There we go. Now we got to turn, and I just got to come off. Okay. Once you crack it, it'll come right off. Let's see, make sure I'm not forgetting anything here. So let's go ahead and put this back on. Start off with the bottom ball joint sliding in. And the axle into spindle. Careful here, we don't want to pop anything apart. Washer. And the nut. frequencies for those screws. Finally went and got myself a new one. Now make sure everything's good and tight. Last but not least, let's get that axle nut tight. That's almost where it was before. Pinch those in. Put the wheel back on. Clean up all of this mess. Take it out for a nice little test drive. I know you guys might have seen this in one of the other videos. Go check out my videos, find this one, comment on it, hit 1,000 subscribers. I'll be giving this away to the most popular comment on the video that I introduced this on. And if you guys like that one, please comment, like, and subscribe. Don't forget to hit that notifications bell so you get any of the new and up and coming videos. Again, about the tool for pressing the caliper pistons back, check out my other videos. Find the video that I introduced the tool, make a comment on that. And when I hit 1,000 subscribers, I will be awarding that tool to whoever has the highest amount of likes, highest comment. And don't forget, you've got no more excuses. Pick up those wrenches. And this, I'm just nick it at an angle.